I want to talk to you today about why red wine is so incredibly good for your health. Well, not really. Not really. I actually want to talk to you about resveratrol, which is why everybody thinks they can drink a bunch of red wine. Resveratrol is one of my favorite, it's a polyphenol, but my favorite nutrients that's out there. And I use it in really just about all my patients. I'm Dr. Andrew Neville, and I specialize in treating adrenal fatigue. And I want to talk to you about why I use resveratrol quite a bit in my practice. Resveratrol is this polyphenol. It exists in red and dark blue, purple fruits, vegetables, things like grapes, of course. Now, realistically, to get as much resveratrol as you need, if you look at the therapeutic dosage, you'd have to drink many, I think it's like 40 liters of red wine a day, which would cause some other problems. So, a little moderate alcohol is fine, but you're not going to get enough resveratrol from red wine. What does resveratrol do? Resveratrol works deep within the cells at changing the cell's survival mechanisms. It actually improves the machinery inside the cells. And this is why the effects of resveratrol are so incredibly diverse, because it gets into the cell, improves the way the cells are working. And now you're talking, whether that's neurons or cardiovascular system or kidney or gut or skin, everywhere. Primary function, it's an excellent antioxidant. Anybody with adrenal fatigue has too much oxidative stress, we deplete our antioxidants. So antioxidants are really important with regard to this. It helps in the brain. A ton it helps in the brain. It's neuroprotective, so it protects nerves from toxins, including oxidation, right, as an antioxidant. But it also stimulates nerve growth factors in the brain, which is powerful, right? So one of the things we're going after with regard to adrenal fatigue and, just in general, right, even in staving off kind of some of the age-related cognitive decline stuff that we develop, we're going after this concept of neuroplasticity, which is really the healing and rewiring of the brain. Incredibly powerful information and awesome research. One of the ways you do that is stimulate these nerve growth factors. The brain can constantly and is constantly changing and healing and remodeling, and resveratrol directly stimulates that. Incredibly powerful. I was just reading a research article as well looking at how resveratrol is one of the molecules that actually can help to clear toxic proteins in the brain that lead to neurodegenerative diseases that are associated with aging. Even things like Parkinson's disease, Huntington's disease, and ALS, and things like that. Some that are genetic, of course, but you add a bunch of aging to that, and even just age-related cognitive decline. One of the other major reasons that I use resveratrol is for mitochondrial biogenesis. Mitochondria, take you back to your high school biology, right? Mitochondria are the little energy producers in all of our cells. What they do is take basically energy from food and turn it into a universal form of energy called ATP that our body can use to do stuff, anything. Detoxify, build a neurotransmitter, think a thought, move a muscle, dependent on mitochondria. Well, that mitochondria is very susceptible to oxidative stress, right? Over time, which comes about because of when our body's in a stress response, that damages the mitochondria. Now we can't efficiently create energy, especially anything related to stamina, right? Energy over time. Not only does resveratrol act as an antioxidant, protect the mitochondria, but it also stimulates mitochondrial biogenesis, the development of new mitochondria within the cells. All cells, which is incredibly powerful. It's unique in that function, one of the only chemicals or molecules that'll do that. Now, when you're thinking about taking resveratrol, getting away from the red wine comments, not all resveratrol is the same. The active form of resveratrol is part of the molecule called trans-resveratrol. And when we're looking at dosage ranges, you're probably looking at like 500 to 1,000 milligrams, typically as far as the therapeutic range gate goes. When we look at kind of the conglomerate of research that's out there, 500 to 1,000 of trans-resveratrol. And it's not cheap, right? Resveratrol is kind of a little pricey. You can find cheap resveratrol, but if it's not trans-resveratrol, you know, you might as well be throwing those capsules in the garbage, because they're not gonna work. But resveratrol is a phenomenal molecule. I use it in the vast majority of my patients, especially because all my patients have adrenal fatigue, too much stress over time, which just creates tremendous wear and tear in our body. But the thing is, we all live in this loud and fast-paced and toxic and kind of obnoxious world. Who doesn't have a little extra wear and tear in their body? So I'd be hard-pressed to think of someone that I wouldn't suggest resveratrol for.